What is going on, guys? Fuxley here. In today's video, we will be reviewing my winter beater, as you can see. So, this is my 1992 Chevlon Plateau. It's an LT trim, and it's basically just in red. Now, I'll go over a backstory behind this in just a little bit, but yeah, let's get straight into it. So, the question that you may ask right off the rip, why are you dailying a 1992 truck on a Roblox game, pretty much? Well, let's just say that people can't drive in RP servers. Cough, GVRP in. So why should I drive my nicer cars? Now does it make sense? So I drive a 1992 truck. And it's not just because I want to, but overall, I just like this year of the Tahoe in general. So it's in this nice red color. We have these, I don't know if you would call these five-spoke wheels, but you have these wheels. I have the covers on. I don't have the bolts showing. It also has a really good stance. It's kind of lifted, I guess you could say. Yeah, it's at a nice stance, so you know, it's not low at all, if you could say that. It sits higher than most SUVs that you see in RP servers, so I really like how it has that road presence. You got the rear right here. It's like my favorite angle right here, just to look at this angle right here. It's just so nice. Got the wheel turn and such. But yeah, let's go over a little backstory. So a few years ago, my neighbor actually had a 1996 Chevy Tahoe in the spec with these wheels and this red color. So therefore, I liked it a lot. So I recreated it in Greenville. And here we go. This is my Tahoe in Greenville. So this is really nice, but now let's get into the interior and review this thing. So we already went over the startup and the cinematic. Let's go over lights and such. So we have our turn signals. I would like what they started doing with the halogen lights on Greenville. It's like a nicer look. It's like a neon look and it fades. So that is like really nice. Not only did they do it with the turn signals on this vehicle, they also did it with the brake lights, as you can see. My brakes are kind of lagging right now, just a typical issue, but I feel like it's only that issue with the rear. It lags every once in a while. Yeah, these neon looks have time to get fixed. But the brake lights, I meant the reverse lights, are also really nice looking, as you can see. Got the white look right there. We turn on our lights, it lights up all of that, but then you brake, it still is being shown really good. Let's check out the headlights. As you see, we have the low beam lights on, and well, the turn signals come on as running lights, I guess you can say, for at night. You got some roof racks, so if you want to put some cross members up there, you can. And let's go into details. So you have the exhaust, and it's not just hanging there. As you can see, it kind of goes up, as they didn't want to model the entire exhaust. But one of my favorite details about this vehicle, we actually have a model differential. If you didn't know, this in the middle is a differential. It basically connects the power to your wheels, as you can see. And this is a four-wheel drive model, so we also have a front differential up there connecting to those wheels. Really good details. We have this lower splitter or diffuser, whatever you want to call it. Ignore the lag spikes. I have to deal with my settings a little bit. These wheels are really nice. Black door handles, they are plastic. And overall, it's just a nice truck. So now let's take it for a little drive. Alrighty, so as you can see, the speedometer only goes up to 100 miles per hour. This is not a fast truck at all, but it's also a really nice truck, in my opinion, at least. You know, I know a lot of y'all Greenville players, y'all are into y'all brand new cars only type stuff, right? Well, I like cars from all years, to be honest, and this is my favorite 1992 vehicle in the game as of right now, other than 454 SS, but you get the point. As you see, it's not the fastest thing that you can buy, but once you're moving, it's pretty much good to go. Let's do an acceleration test. We're actually going to launch it. So as you can see, it goes from 0 to 30 that quickly. But for a 1992 truck, it does exactly what you would want it to do. This is not a race car. So if you need to get to highway speeds, it can do just that. If you need it to go everywhere, it can do just that. But at a cost. This thing takes $100 to fill up on Greenville. I've done this before. I actually got it to around 97 or 98. I don't remember because I still had 4% left. So that extra 4% probably would have took it up to $100. So yeah, it's very expensive to fill up, but it's also a nice truck to cruise in. It's really nice. And I still can't get over the way this sits. I love how it sits. It has a nice kind of look to it when it sits this high off the ground. Really nice. All right, so we're gonna test out the turning radius. We're just gonna do a U-turn right here. So full lock and turn. So yeah, you can do a U-turn just into the opposite lane. So yeah, I don't think you can do lane to lane in this vehicle unless you turned right a little bit. Yeah, see, you're gonna have to go in the other lane just a little bit, but other than that, you can do a nice and complete U-turn. So say you're cruising, let's get up to 55 real quick. All right, almost there. Like I said, not fast at all. All right, so say you're cruising, but you need the 5 car lengths to get over. So once this hill goes ahead and clears up, we will try that test out. So you're turning on your turn signal, sport mode. You know, it has decent amount of power, I guess you can say. As you see, it was barely moving, but hey, it is what it is, I guess. But yeah, y'all, there's nothing else really to this vehicle. If you like what you see, go ahead and cop it in Greenville. This is my winter daily. So if you like it, go ahead, cop you one. You don't want all your new cars getting destroyed, or you just want something that you can mess around with and you don't care about getting dirty. Of course, I cleaned it for this video, but yeah. If you enjoyed today's video, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And yeah, this has been Vuxery, and I am Black.